In this video, let's explain how to use font size and weight in a UI to express the content's hierarchical structure. This will help you to design UIs that look even better and that are easier to use. But first, let's go over a few key terms, shall we? Content hierarchy is the strategic placement of information on a page. So the better a developer uses typography in the hierarchy, the easier it is for users to grasp the page's purpose. By placing the most important content at the top of the page and the supporting information below, the purpose becomes clear. Typography is the art of arranging a message in a readable and aesthetically pleasing way. A typeface describes a style of lettering such as Arial or Times New Roman, and a font refers to typeface variations, like its size and weight such as Arial Bold 16 point. Now let's take a look at this UI. By default, the Reach Text component uses the standard text configuration. Let's see how we can edit the default font size and weight to make the readability of the page even better. First, I'll increase the font size on the title Return to Work Readiness Questionnaire to Large Plus Text. The statement below the title to Medium, and the subtitle Work Location and the question on the right to Large Text. Now, you can notice that since increasing the font size, how quickly your eyes go to the top of the page, emphasizing its importance, influencing what is read first, second, and third. Now, secondly, I'll be bolding the subheading Work Location and change it to blue. Then use bold for the labels country and office. Modifying the subheading pulls your gaze downward, calling attention to it. Modifying the page hierarchy with varying font sizes helps the user navigate the page effortlessly and organizes the information. Repeating bold and regular text on the labels unifies them by presenting the same ideas in the page's organizational hierarchy. Lastly, you can alter the character and personality of your UI using custom typefaces, because a typeface can be more or less formal. Let's have a look at a couple of examples illustrating the impact of custom typefaces, such as sans serif and serif. Here's an example of a sans serif font, sometimes considered more minimalist or casual. And here's an example of a serif font, which are considered to be more classic or formal. Now, if you want more information on how to configure those typefaces, you can check out the Appian documentation in the custom typefaces page. In summary, the larger headline text dominates the page, influencing the order of what the user sees. Using a bold face can pull the user's eye towards whatever the bold text is highlighting. Applying the same combination of font size and weight unifies page elements like labels, and customizing the typeface can communicate personality. If you want more guidance about modifying rich text in your UIs, you can refer to the SAIL Design System Guidance available for rich text at design.appian.com. If you want to learn more about user interface design in general, you can visit us at Academy Online. And if you want, you can get a free Appian Community Edition environment to try all of this out. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more design tips, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.